But before starting to talk about bad practices, let's discuss some best practices, right? And what I'm going to tell here is based on chapter 5 of the Pragmatic Unit Testing book. And the chapter is called First Properties of Good Tests. And it is first because F-I-R-S-T, each letter means something. And that's what we're going to explore now. So the first F stands for fast. And tests should be fast. Of course, it is pretty hard to draw a line between what is a fast test and what is a slow test. But if you have a very slow test, in practice, what happens is that developers don't run them all the time. And that's what you want from tests. You want them to be very timely. You do a change, you run the test, you see whether it fails or if it passes. So in practice, what we try to do to have a fast test is to try to minimize the amount of dependencies on slow things. And we've actually studied a way to do this, which was mock objects. So whenever you're writing a test, make sure that this test is fast enough so that it gives you feedback in a fast way. I stands for isolated. And when we write a test, we want this test to be isolated in different perspectives. So the first one is in terms of what it tests. So we want our test to test an isolated piece of functionality. And good unit tests usually focus on a small chunks of code. And good unit tests are also isolated when it comes to the other tests that are there in our test suite. We don't want to write a test that depends on another test so that we have some sort of strange execution ordering that is required for the test suite to work. I need to execute test one before executing test two, you know? So tests should be isolated from each other. And for that to happen, you need to really be careful with any shared resources. For example, if you're using the same database in different tests, you need to make sure that each test puts its own data in the database, and then it cleans the data afterwards, so that what happens in one test doesn't affect the next test. Then R stands for repeatable. And a repeatable test is the one that always produces the same results whenever you run it, regardless of many times you run it. We don't want tests that pass sometimes and fail some other times, or to present different results every time we run them. Of course, if they keep giving different results, we will lose our trust on them. And to achieve repeatable tests, what we need to do is to make sure that our tests are really well isolated. If there's anything that can interfere on the tests, they will start failing for unknown reasons. So repeatable tests are very related to isolated tests. S stands for self-validating. Tests are only automated tests if they automatically assert that things went as expected. So if you have a test without an assertion, in any way that you can write an assertion, then this is not a good automated test. We don't want to manually verify the results of tests, right? So the test has to be self-validating. And of course, as long as we're discussing about self-validating, a test should also be self-arranging, meaning the test is also responsible for making sure that all the required initial state is there before the test runs. So again, with the database example, if my test needs a database to be set up with a certain data in there, these tests should be responsible for doing it. So self-validating and self-arranging tests are fundamental. And finally, T stands for timely. And we're not only talking about the code we write right now, but also about our development process. You need to make sure that automated testing becomes a habit. You should become test-infected, as we say in the community. You should write tests all the times. In practice, we see that if you leave the automated test for later, to after the software is done, or to after a release is done, odds are that you're not going to do them. At some point, we're going to talk about test-driven development, or TDD, which is the idea to write the tests even before the production code. But at this moment, what I want you to have in mind is that you should write tests all the time in a frequent way. So these are the first principles. And these are the principles I want you to always have in mind when designing and writing automated tests. Now it is time for us to see some test mails.